सच्चिदानंद रूपिणं वंदे सनातनं पुण्यं नित्यानंदा.
Let us work on the next layer of patterns, guilt. See, first fear, then greed. After the greed, the complication of fear and greed together is guilt. Guilt is basically the incompletion of the past. Incompletion of the past moment you carry into your present and future. See, it's like a trying to measure, look at your past incidents with the updated intelligence. For example, I'll give you an example. At the age of 6-7, you are playing with a toy, your mother comes and calls you for eating, but you feel playing is so important, you say, no, I won't come for eating, you eat. Then your mother forcibly tries you, take you for eating, she just takes away the toys. Immediately the child starts crying, ah, you die, you give me my toy. And now, if you sit and start worrying, oh, now you know mother is more important than the toy. But at that time, you had only that much of intelligence. That's the reason you felt toys are more important than the mother. But if you start worrying for the ideas, concepts, decisions you had at that time, with the updated intelligence, is there going to be any end for it? No. It is going to be just a worrying process. Logically, it will never end. It will never conclude. Guilt is one of the root cause of human suffering, the human conditioning. Guilt is nothing but wasting your time, energy, and your consciousness. Please see, first the three layers of guilt, how you form guilt, how you create guilt. Go back to your early childhood, typically between age 3 to 7, recollect and describe the incidents where the seed of guilt was sown in you with regards to your own body. For example, when your parents stopped you from playing with your own body, usually kids put the hand in the mouth or leg in the mouth and play with their own body. When you stop that, kind of a disturbance starts happening in a child. And second, go back to your early adolescence, typically between 7 to 14 years of age, recollect and describe the incidents where the seeds of guilt related to sex were sown in you. Third, go back to your early adulthood, years between 15 to 23 years, and recollect the guilt that you accumulated because you experienced failure in fulfilling the needs of the people who depend on you, like your spouse, boyfriend, your kids, your parents, your friends. Same way, the second sheet, that is identifying the root guilts, root guilt pattern. How you build guilt pattern. Please take the second sheet. Go back to your early childhood and recollect the first incident when you had the experience that something was wrong with you. First time, how the society tries to make you feel that something is wrong with you. Describe the incidents and your experience vividly. Identify and write down the areas of your life where you experience and express this guilt even now. For example, if they made you feel your handwriting is not good, it is very ugly, even now you will be feeling that when you write. Go back to your early teenage years and recollect the incident when you had the experience that you did not belong to a group or groups of people. For example, an incident where you felt you did not belong to your family anymore, an incident where you did not belong to your community anymore. Describe the incident and your experience vividly and write down areas of your life where you experience and express this guilt even now. Third, go back to your adulthood years and recollect the incident when you had the experience that you are all alone in life from now on. See, sometimes you break from the social hypocrisy. So, same way, sometime you would have been broken or disillusioned by the society. When that happened, describe. And fourth, scan your life and pen down all the guilts that you are currently carrying in your life. Describe them clearly. Understand? When you describe, relive them. Reliving is relieving. When you consciously bring it up and relive, it will be completely erased from your system. You just bring it up to your consciousness. I'll take care of erasing it from your consciousness. Start. Totally 7 questions. Then the whole thing will be heard. Okay? Now, please put your papers aside. Everything aside. Spread all over the hall. Please spread all over the hall. We'll start the kriya to break the pattern of guilt. See, guilt is formed as a pattern in you. Whenever you are in low mood, your body is in low mood, guilt is formed. You don't need a reason from outside to form a guilt. If you are in low mood, you can form a guilt. Oh, it is such a beautiful weather, but I am sitting inside the hall. You can start feeling guilt. Please spread all over the hall. Sit in Vajrasana. Sit in Vajrasana. Vajrasana means sitting on your knees. Start the intense chanting of Hunkara, H-O-O, sound. Please understand. Voice, the sound should come out through your mouth, and along with sound, exhale. Visualize all your guilt, memories are leaving you along with the sound, along with exhaling. Ooh, 3 things. Sound, hunkara, through the mouth. Second, exhale as much as you can. When you can't exhale anymore, body will automatically inhale. Third, visualize along with this sound, all your guilt patterns are leaving you. If you are heart patient or high blood pressure or any other serious illness, if you are a special attention needed participant, please sit in a normal posture and do it very slowly. Don't do violently or strongly. Do it very slowly, as much as you can. Don't force yourself. Please tie the ribbon. Best consciousness. Let your inner space be free from the guilt and guilt patterns. Let the source of guilt be destroyed and you be free. Relax. You can open your eyes.